Let me begin by asking you about the first line on your report. You're talking about your credit ratio, proportional upgrades to downgrades, for the first half of this financial year at 0.87 times. What is the inference that one makes out of this?
See, the study that we have put out is essentially a semi-annual study that we do to put out the trends in the credit quality that we see in the environment. And this study essentially represents all the ratings that we have outstanding, which is close to 12,500 companies. And together they constitute close to 40% of the bank's credit outstanding. So which implies that it really is representative of what we are seeing in the credit quality trends in corporate India. Mm. The trend or the ratio of upgrade to downgrade, the credit ratio, essentially indicates whether more companies are facing challenges, are getting downgraded, or more companies are getting upgraded, and essentially indicating that the trend on credit quality, where is it headed? So 0.87 implies that the more the ratio is below 1, it implies that the pressure is high. And if you look at it in the context of what we have seen over the past 2 years, you will notice that the ratio has stayed below 1 for now nearly 2 years. And the ratio has actually been declining for almost now 3 years. Mm. I think that is something which puts the context on the credit quality pressure that the corporate India is facing today.
Pavan, when you look at what companies are doing, and if you look at their P&Ls, if you look at the credit ratings at this point in time, are corporates borrowing more to service their own debt, or is it to meet their working capital requirements? How are you reading this, and is this getting any better?
I think the indebtedness levels are high, primarily on account of the stretch in receivables that we see. Mm. And the funding of the receivables increase is primarily happening through some amount of additional debt. We are not able to see companies able to raise too much of an equity, primarily from sectors which are facing a substantial amount of stretch in liquidity or working capital. So to that extent, the debt levels are really rising. We are also seeing the debt levels continue to remain high in investment-driven sectors, construction, real estate, infrastructure projects, where the cash accruals are not appropriately enough to be able to meet the equity or the investment requirements which are there, or the projects are not necessarily able to generate cash flow from the operations.
Sure. What does this mean for the banking system? You know, several people have expressed concerns over the rising NPA levels of banks, both public sector and private sector banks. How does this reflect on the books of banks?
I think clearly the banks will reflect the pressure that we are seeing on the larger economy and the credit quality. So we are obviously seeing that the pressure on asset quality of banking sector is building up. We have seen that the NPAs, gross NPAs, have increased over the last couple of years. Our expectation is that NPAs will continue to rise and reach about 4.4% of the system's advances by end of March 14. But more importantly, there is another indicator that we track, which is called the weak assets ratio. And this weak assets ratio is a combination of the reported gross NPAs and about 30% of the restructured assets that the banks have. And if we look at the weak assets number is likely to increase to about 5.7% by March 14, vis-a-vis about 4.3% as at March 13. And I think that is what essentially represents the pressure that we are seeing on the asset quality.